Oh, man, it was fun to be recognized as the number one actor on Netflix. I'm pretty much in more shows or movies than anybody. So, yeah, I mean, you know, to be singled out as that is a pretty good feeling. You know, it's a testament of hard work tasting great. And it's also a step closer to my ultimate goal of getting a series regular role. I have yet to be a series regular on any of these, but yet I still get recognized as, you know, this big part of Netflix universe. So it's fun.
The Marvel shows on Netflix each had a very different character, a very different tone. What was it like to be one of the few characters that really was a bridging point for those series and kind of popped up in all of them at some point?
Man, you know, it was a beautiful feeling being that Turk Barrett, he's pretty much the connecting glue to the whole universe. And to have that kind of responsibility and play it out and do it in such a way that people take it as fun and comedy and, you know, they really get excited when my character pops up. I mean, man, who wouldn't want to get that kind of reception as a storyteller and an actor? So I love being that guy, yeah.
The lineup of talent in our Defenders cast is pretty sensational. Can you talk about, I mean, was there a particular highlight for you, one person in particular or one show that you had the most fun on for one reason or another?
Oh, man. I would say Luke Cage, probably. My man Mike Coulter was phenomenal to work with. Ron Cephas Jones, Frankie Faison, you know, all them brothers was just phenomenal. Mahershala Ali, you know, it was just a great synergy on cast. Simone Missick, the names could keep going on and on and on, but yeah, I gotta say that Luke Cage experience was something special. Even though I only had like a couple episodes, but I felt that my presence was very, very special, yeah.
One of the most exciting things, particularly looking to the future for Marvel, is that question of representation. And of course, Mahershala has just been confirmed as our new Blade, and we've got a lot of series. Can you talk about how important that element of the MCU is for you, particularly having heroes like Luke Cage and Blade front and center going forward?
Oh, man, it's very important, especially when we live in a society where our presence is devalued oftentimes in media, either through justice or police brutality or even just in representation. We're hardly ever seen. So for us to have a place that can show a different side, show various color hues of our community, and speak to us in a way that we can receive it well, I think that's very, very important. And I hope that it opened the door for many more to come.